Hello and welcome to this week's episode of Blender for Beginners. In this week's episode, we're going to look at 3D sculpting. So far, we've looked at 3D modeling and animation in Blender and how we use extrusion modeling and box modeling to create meshes, how we can texture them, and how we can make them appear to move. This week, we're going to look at something slightly different, and it's a different way of working, and it's the excellent sculpt mode in Blender. Now, sculpting is similar to 3D modeling, but it's a more kind of artistic way, some would argue, of creating 3D models. I myself like modelling, but sculpting is also great. First thing you've got to do to go into sculpting in Blender is go down to where it says object mode, click and select the sculpt mode. Okay, and that's put us in sculpting mode, and we can tell because on the left hand side we've got these sculpting brush tools. What we need to do though is, if we try and sculpt at the moment, what we'll find difficult is when we try and sculpt is it's only really very basically deforming our mesh. And that's because if I hit Z on my keyboard to have a look at the wireframe, we've got a very simple mesh that's comprised of six faces and 8 vertices, and that's all. And because of that, it's finding it very difficult to sculpt. Sculpting requires a high poly model. That means you've got to have lots of polygons, lots of vertices for it to work. So what we need to do, the first thing we need to do, is add a modifier that's going to subdivide our model. So to do that, we go to the Modifiers tab up here, which is the spanner icon, click Add Modifier, and we're going to select the Multi-Resolution modifier, which is a great modifier that will subdivide our model. And here you see we've got the Modifier tab, and there's a Subdivide button. If we click that, you'll see that the poly count and the vertices are increasing every time we'd hit it, and we're going to take that up to 5 to start with. Now, benefits of a high poly model are you can go into much more detail, but the drawbacks, of course, is a high poly model requires more rendering time, and it will slow down your computer. If you've got a computer that's not very good, be warned, the more time you hit that subdivide button, the slower your computer's going to get, and the more likely it is that it will crash. So, I've left mine at 5, and that should be fine to start off with. And I'm going to hit Z on my keyboard and go back to my normal view mode. So, there we go, we can see our mesh there. If I start to draw, so I'm going to hold down the left button on my mouse now and move my mouse around, so I'm going to start to draw on the model. You'll see that sculpting involves editing your model, not by extruding individual faces, polygons and vertices and transforming them, but by almost kind of drawing on the features onto the model. So there we go. So that's the basic sculpting. One thing that's interesting that we can see straight away is whatever I've done on this side of the model, it's mirrored it on that side. That's because underneath the brush tool over here on the left hand side, we've got some symmetry options underneath the symmetry tab. So at the minute I've set it to mirror on the x-axis, press Z, Control Z to go back. I could also set it to mirror on the z-axis, for example. Whatever I do there, it's done at the bottom as well. Or I could set it to mirror on the y-axis. There we go, you see it's done exactly the same there. Or I can set it to do it on all the axes, so whatever I do there, it will do on all sides of the model. Benefits of symmetry are that it cuts down your modelling time. If you're doing an organic model, for example a human or an animal, that is normally symmetrical, you only have to do it on one side and it will do it on the other side for you. Okay, so symmetry tools are very, very useful. What we're going to have a look at next is going to be the curve tool. This is to do with the falloff of the brush effect, so I've done it there. The falloff is represented in a graphical curve. I'm going to use the very angular curve, so we've got a much more pronounced falloff there, and that's simulated by the, if you have a look at the icon, it's almost like half a box, very straight lines, angular 90 degrees. There's lots of other different curve options you could use, and depending what effect you're going for, you want to pick those. So let's go back to that one there. One very interesting thing about Blender's sculpting tools is the texture settings. Now, texturing in Blender normally refers to applying an image to your model to create a certain look. What we're going to use texturing for with sculpting is to apply it to a brush tip, almost like a stamp that you apply to your brush tip. At the moment when I draw, it's just drawing in a very plain way, there's no particular texture applied to my brush tip. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go across to the texture tab on the right hand side. I'm going to click new, and what we can do is where it says image or movie, we can select any of Blender's inbuilt kind of textures. We've got magic there, let's have a look at wood. So I'm going to increase my brush size, and when I go left to right with them, I think we can see, there you go, that the texture, the brush tip is mirroring the lines there. Let's have a look at another one. Let's go for marble, for example. And we can see that what I've drawn on there, or what I've sculpted on, is mirroring the texture there. Probably the easiest way to see this is if I go back a few steps. I'm just going to get rid of my textures there. We can also make, so we can import in textures to make our own brush tips. So what I'm going to do this, I'll show you. Select image or movie like you would for a normal texture. Click open to find where you've saved your image. Now, I've saved mine on desktop. Earlier on, I created a star image. We've got the star there that we can see. And here we go. And now if I start to draw on my image there, you should be able to see, there's the star. It's not very pronounced at the minute, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to subdivide my model a couple more times, increase the strength, and got the radius, that seems to be okay. My fall off seems to be alright too. And here we go. And there we go, we can see if we have a look at, oh, there's the texture that we've applied to the brush tip, and we can see that Blender's drawing that on. That's obviously very useful for if you've got features on your model and you want to make a bespoke brush to paint them on, maybe veins, maybe skin, it might be a particular texture like a wood grain or something, then we can do that. And what we'll do is we'll just save this texture now, so go back into your texture tab, and I'm going to save this as star texture by typing that in the name, hit return, and when I hit my texture, we see the star texture is saved there. If we click X to get rid of that over this side, I'm going to make another new texture. Same again, image removal, click open, navigate to my textures folder. Just find, there we go, wood planks, that'll do. Save this as wood brush texture. And then if I left click over on the left hand side on the texture, we can see I can still select the star texture or the wood. Let's draw on that wood texture, there we go. We see that that's a much more different texture style that it's got going on there. So, there we go, that's how to create textures. Another interesting thing about Blender's sculpting tools is that as well as the sculpt draw tool, if we left click that, we've also got other tools. So we've got grab tools, we've got a flatten tool. If I try and flatten out this star here, there we go, we can see it's trying to flatten it down. I could grab tool, so I'm going to try and grab the point of that star and move it around. We can see I've done that. Another thing you can do is if you need to smooth out your texture, if you hold shift on your keyboard and left click, it will smooth. And if I go back to my star texture, go back into brush, another thing we can do is as well as drawing on and sculpting on our things, we can also subtract them. So if I make sure in brush mapping, by the way, that you've got it set to area plane for this. If you click the subtract button here, instead of drawing on the effect, you'll sculpt in. If I click add and do the same thing, you'll see it comes out. So, that's a very basic instruction to sculpting mode in Blender. Good luck, and I hope to see some of your work.